Hands, how many people have purchased a cell phone or a vehicle in the last year? In the last 5 years? Name one thing that may have been different from a vehicle or a phone that you purchased several years prior to that.
GPS system.
GPS system.
No CD player.
No CD player.
Price.
Price. These are all great things. See, in life, it's the innovation that's the key. Meaning, you don't have to reinvent the wheel. Let's take the car, for instance. Every time a car comes out, it's usually the next year. Every time a cell phone comes out, it's usually within 6 months to the next year. Computers, so forth and so on. You don't have to reinvent the wheel. Every time a new product comes out, it's just made to be 10% better. Would everybody agree with that? Just a little bit better. If I were to hold this up, what would you call this?
A rock.
Stone.
At one time, people called this a hammer. Maybe one time, a weapon. In 1975, a gentleman by the name of Gary Dahl, while sitting in a restaurant with some of his friends, complaining about how they had to walk their animals, how they had to feed them, how they had to take them to the vet. Gary Dahl took a couple more drinks of his favorite elixir. And he said, I got it. We'll make a pet rock. See, some of us are at that age where we do remember the pet rock, some others maybe not. But all Gary Dahl did was take an idea that was already present. The concept of a rock, he made it 10% better. What he did was take a cardboard box, fill it with straw, poke holes in the box so that the animal could breathe, this being the animal. He gave it a name, and then he began to market it. In less than a year, Gary Dahl was made a millionaire. Steve Jobs just once said this about innovation. He said, innovation is what distinguishes a leader from a follower. Innovation is the key. Now, how do we apply this to our lives? Can we make ourselves 10% better? The job is to ABI, always be improving. Our job is to always better our best. Become 10% better. Become cutting edge. So how do we do this? How do we turn our regular selves into our 3.0 selves? Well, if our issue is health, we can begin to do like I did. Lace up the tennis shoes and hit the pavement. As you can see, I'm starting to wear my tight shirts again. A couple of weeks ago, this shirt didn't fit. But I'm slimming into the new me. What else can we do? Further our education. How many people have gone to college to make themselves better? To improve themselves that little bit more? To give us that cutting edge on innovation? What else can we do? What all of us in this room have done. Join Toastmasters International, where leaders are made. I'm not sure why more people don't join this organization. Pound for pound for the money we pay, this is, in my opinion, one of the greatest organizations there is to improve one's personal and professional status. To give us that edge, to be innovative, to be 10% better than we were yesterday. To be able to surround ourselves with people who may be smarter than we are. Maybe people who are going the same places that we've already been, and we can give them the experience. See, we surround ourselves with Toastmasters week by week, month by month, year by year. We go to conferences to hang around like-minded individuals to sharpen our own talents, to sharpen our own skills, to be better than we were the day before, to ABI, always be improving. So I want you to think about innovation and why innovation is the key. I want you to think about this. Think about if we do what we've always done, we'll be who we've always been. If we do what we've always done, we'll be who we've always been. Sometimes that's not a bad thing. But in a society like ours that's evolving, that's always moving forward, where innovation is the key in our society, how good we were yesterday isn't necessarily going to sustain us tomorrow. And we see that as we go to our corporate jobs, as we find ourselves with our gray hairs and find ourselves looking in the mirror, finding ourselves getting older. And because the market is new and fresh, they want to go and get that kid right out of high school, that kid right out of college. Our old models of ourselves become outdated. We have to get to the point where we are improving that 10%. Always be improving. Always better your best. Ladies and gentlemen, innovation is the key. Toastmasters.